Burping. It can be loud. It can be quiet. It can be socially acceptable. It can be gross. But how does the process work? And when does burping become a sign of a more serious problem? Today, we're going to look at the different types of burp, or belch, as the doctors politely call them. And we'll see what they tell you about what's going on inside. So, grab a fizzy drink and eat all the beans you want. It's burping time on today's episode by Health Chronicle. For regular, healthy people, burping is a way to release the extra gas in your stomach. As a natural part of eating, you swallow small amounts of air along with your food. It normally doesn't make it down to your stomach, so it builds into a small bubble in your esophagus. The amount of gas trapped here increases if you eat fast, because you breathe in while you're shoveling in that delicious food. Chewing gum can have a similar effect. The gas from carbonated drinks typically adds to the bubble. Although this isn't air, it's carbon dioxide. When little babies are breastfeeding, they swallow air because they are sucking. This can give them colic, which is a pain in the abdomen caused by trapped air. That's why parents burp their babies, by patting and rubbing them gently on the back. However, research from 2015 looked at 71 sets of mothers and babies and found that burping didn't reduce the chance of colic, and, in fact, it only increased the chance that the baby would regurgitate some of the milk. But for us extra-large babies, or adults, burping can also be a sign of a bigger problem. The most common issue is acid reflux, more commonly known as heartburn. Around 60% of adults will experience acid reflux in a year, and 20 to 30% will have it once a week. What happens is some of your stomach acid accidentally comes up towards your esophagus. This acid is what causes the burning sensation and often leads to burping with a bad taste in your mouth. This usually happens because of the food remaining undigested in the stomach, due to low stomach acid. Yes, that's right. Did you know that you feel acidity because of low stomach acid, not high? Yeah. Look it up. Low stomach acid causes the food to remain undigested, and this food travels back up into the esophagus and causes acid reflux. There are plenty of treatments for the symptoms, such as milk, antacids, and many others. But if it occurs twice a week or more, then you will need medical advice, as acid reflux can damage your esophagus in the long term and increase your risk of cancer. Burping can also be linked to chronic ailments such as hiatal hernias or gallstones. Now let's talk about smell. Yeah, gross. We know. Of course, if you just ate a prawn burrito with pickled garlic, it's no surprise that your burp won't smell like a summer meadow. But if you often get a strong, bad odor when belching, it's a sign that your digestive system isn't working as it should. As you can see, from all the examples mentioned before, there are multiple areas that could be causing the issue, but a bad smell is often a bad sign. So how do you get your burping to come down? Well, there are a few things you can do to help with this. Most important thing is to not skip a meal and eat your meals at regular timings every day. For example, eating breakfast every day at 7 a.m. lets your body expect a heavy meal and to be prepared accordingly. This helps aiding digestion. Secondly, have an early dinner. Having your dinner latest by 7 p.m. is key in controlling your burps and making sure your digestion works well. Thirdly, eat a cooked meal, low in protein and rich in greens to help develop natural gut microflora. This would restore and maintain a healthy gut microflora. Lastly, avoid smoking and drinking alcohol altogether. No. These habits do more harm than good and can really damage the gut bacteria and pH of the body, causing more bloating and belching. Following all this will make you feel your burping come down and will make your digestive system much stronger. You may be wondering how to make all these changes to your lifestyle suddenly. Watch our video on how to start a healthy lifestyle. Maybe that would help you out. You can also click on the left to subscribe to our channel for weekly videos on how to make your tomorrow a little bit healthier than today.